Welcome back students. This is part 2 of today's lecture. Now I'll be discussing about the tuples in Python. See, what is a tuple? We know, again, it is a data type. As we have read strings, we read lists. Now we will be reading out tuples. So this is another type of data type which has certain similarities with strings and tuples and certain dissimilarities also. That too we'll be reading in our coming lecture. Okay, let me start it now. Tuple is basically identified with the help of this parenthesis, means this round bracket will help you to identify that it is a tuple. For string we needed double quotes in to write inside. Matlab, everything is to be written inside these parentheses, but in double quotes or single quotes, right? But for list, we use that square brackets we just read in our previous lectures. But for tuples, we'll be using these round brackets. So tuples can be of different format, means there can be an empty tuple as we had empty list. Next, we can have elements inside it, one element, many elements. But one thing we need to always remember is that whenever we are writing one element inside a tuple, it must always add comma after it. Means we need to add it, otherwise it will take it as a value, not as a tuple. Okay, so here it is discussing the same. T is equals to 1 if we are writing and we are not putting comma. So it will assume ki T has been assigned value 1. It will not consider it's a tuple containing only one value. So you need to put comma after it. Always put comma if you are giving just single value inside the tuple. Okay. So this is also a tuple which is containing integers only. This is a tuple which is a combination of integer and floating point numbers, right? Then this is a tuple which is a group of characters. This is a tuple which is a mixed combination of different data types, right? This is a tuple of strings, right? And we know these tuples are immutable. This is the very first difference. If you are talking about list and tuple difference, then tuples are immutable. We know very well immutable means we cannot change the values of these tuples as we were changing the values in the list. Fine. So if you'll try to change these values once you have added, then it will give you error. You can replace the whole tuple, but you cannot replace a single value inside the tuple. Fine. Next point is how to create tuple. How to create? We just need to put values inside this round brackets, and we need to use a tuple object, we can say, or we can say a tuple variable. Similarly, as we have read in strings and lists, similar is the case here. How to create an empty tuple? Don't write anything inside this. Okay, either you use these round brackets, this will also identify to means it's a tuple, or you can use this keyword tuple, this will also create a tuple. Fine. This problem I have discussed here also, means you need to write comma after the first element even if you are not adding anything inside your tuple. How to create tuples from existing sequence means we can create our tuple from strings, lists, or tuples also. So how to create that, let us discuss now. T is equals to t1 is equals to tuple hello, means this is your string, and with the help of this string we are going to create a tuple. So this tuple will have all the values in the form of each element inside this tuple. Fine. Now this is a list and we are going to construct our tuple from this particular list. So what we need to do, tuple l is the name of this list variable, and we are passing this list variable to this tuple. So earlier it was having the square brackets, now it will be having round brackets because it has now been converted into tuple. How to create a tuple from your keyboard input? keyboard input means you will be using the input function, or you will be using the eval function to take input from the user by means of keyboard. So whatever input you are taking from this input function will be written in the form of this format, in the tuple format. Fine. Similarly, you can take eval. We have used these two functions in your lists also. We have discussed these two functions there also. Similar is the case here also. Now I'll be discussing what are the differences or the similarities between the tuple and the list. So firstly, we'll go with similarities. So tuples and how these tuples and list are similar. Length function we can use to calculate the number of items that are present inside a tuple or a list. So length function is the same function which are common among these two, tuples and list. Okay, next point of similarity is indexing and slicing. Means we are using indexes to refer to the each element of the tuple. Fine, this will be a 0th element, this is your first element, second element, third element, fourth element, so on. See, you have you ever noticed we are giving different data types here, these two are numbers, this is a string, again this is a string of different type, this is a list even. So tuple can have lists also inside it. How I identify it's a list? With the help of these square brackets. Fine. Next, slicing also we can do in tuples, as we have done slicing in lists to create another sublist. So here we'll be creating a subtuple out of it. Membership operators, in and not in, as we were using in lists, strings. So similar is case here, we'll be allowed to use in and not in operators. Next is concatenation and application operators, plus to add two strings, and the star operator to replicate. Fine. So next is your accessing individual elements. How to access the individual element? You just need to use that particular index. Fine. So if you want to get this U printed, so what you will write, vowels index 4. So it will refer to this particular value and give it in the form of output. Minus 1, as we read in strings and list, we have two types of indexes, forward index and backward index. So minus 1 also refers to this particular element. We can go with forward index 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and we can refer to the backward index, which is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5. So either you write minus 1 or you write 4, you will get the same output. Now the differences between the tuples and the list. First difference is tuples are mutable, not mutable, and lists are mutable. Means if you try to change the value of the element, will not be able to do this. We have discussed this point n number of times in chapter 1, in chapter 2 as well. So again, it is a repetition. Next is the tuple operations. Tuple operations, first is traversal. Traversal, again, it is similar to the list. Means accessing each and every element that is present inside the tuple. For that, we need to use a for loop. So before that, we need to define a tuple. So t is the tuple variable here, and we are putting elements inside this tuple. How I identify it's a tuple? With the help of these round brackets. Fine. So we are using a variable a in t, which will be referring to the each element of this particular tuple. So it will print all the elements of these tuple. Why they are coming in next line? By default, they will come in next line. Fine, we know this. In lists also, we found that if you are printing a tuple or a list, each element of it will come in a new line. You need not mention any new line character for taking them to the new line. Next is your joining of tuple. How you will join? With the help of this concatenation operator. So two tuples can be joined together with the help of this. TP1 contains 135 and TP2 contains 678. So once we are using these concatenation operators, the two tuples will be added together. Fine. Next is your one important point to notice: if you are adding a integer to a string, it will go wrong, it will give you error also. Next is repetition or the replication tuples. So for that, for repeating a tuple number of times, you need to use this star operator or replication operator as we have done in the lists. Fine. So your tuple was 135, 135, 135. So it has been repeated 3 times. Fine. Slicing the tuples. This topic will be continuing in our next video of today's lecture only. Thank you.